Welcome back. Now, the playwright Joe Orton shocked audiences in the 60s with his black comedies. What the Butler Saw was the last one he wrote and was produced 2 years after his untimely death. It's now on in Cambridge, starring Michael Pennington and Jane Asher. But the question is, does Orton still have the power to shock?
It's quite interesting how it still has bits that are shocking, although in a very different way than they would have been all that time ago. It's quite surprising. I mean, things like, it's awful talking about these things, but incest, for instance. I mean, he makes fun of everything. You know, there are no subjects that are taboo in the world of Orton. But the fact that there are jokes, albeit very funny jokes, about such a horrific subject, it has acquired quite a different tone now.
You're spreading it around that I'm a transvestite, aren't you?
There was a woman's shoe hidden in the fish tank. What was it doing there?
What were you doing rooting about in the fish tank?
Dr. Rance and I are trying to help you. We're not satisfied with your condition.
Oh, neither am I. It's impossible, and you're to blame. Should have driven you out with ignominy years ago.
Whose fault is it if our marriage is on the rocks? You're selfish and inconsiderate. Don't push me too far.
Michael Pennington plays a sex-obsessed psychiatrist and Jane Asher his nymphomaniac wife. His clinic becomes a bedlam of mistaken identity, undressing and cross-dressing.
I might sleep with someone else.
Oh.
An Indian student.
You don't know any.
New Delhi is full of them.
You can't take lovers in Asia. The airfare would be crippling. Your irresponsible behaviour causes me untold anxiety. A man showed himself to you last summer.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, and your disappointment marred our holiday.
You've no psychological understanding of the difficulties I face.
Unless you're very careful, you'll find yourself in a suitcase awaiting collection.
These veiled threats confirm the doubts I already have of your sanity.
You can see What the Butler Saw at the Cambridge Arts Theatre tomorrow night and twice on Saturday. Then it moves to the Milton Keynes Theatre from the 30th of July to the 4th of August. And now for Cara's interview with the musician Ed Harcourt at the Waterfront in Norwich.
Let's move away together, go into the planetary. Where it's sanitary.
You've got a new album out, Hear Me Monsters. That's a very curious title. What's behind that?
It's very ambivalent, the title. You can draw many different interpretations from it. For instance, a lot of the journalists who write about the album, when they review it, they sort of start talking about, you know, it being a sort of uncharted seas, you know, because I'm a new artist, and
right.
Which is one take on it. And the other take, my take, is that the songs are these little monsters that fly out into the public eye, having been written by me for myself.
Definitely miss me when I'm gone.
I wanted to write a song that wasn't too apologetic, a love song that was quite sort of twisted.
Well, there's a thousand things I shouldn't do, but if I do them, I should do them with you.
You write some really amazing love songs, and you're...
Yeah, I can't stop doing it, it's really bad. I actually say that in one of the songs, She Fell Into My Arms, I'm saying, God, you make me sing funny things about you, and it's like,
yeah. It's
like, will you stop, you know, can I stop being in love with you so I, you know, I don't write these songs? I should write about death or something, you know. I should do that as well.
Moving like a dancing bear, it's in my blood. Falling down the marble stairs, it's in my blood.
The album was co-produced with Tim Holmes. How did that collaboration come about?
I chose him because I really like Death in Vegas, and Jeff Barrett from Heavenly was he's very good at making inspired decisions as far as collaboration is concerned. I mean, he was more engineering, but he was coming up. I got him because he had like samplers and synths and computers and stuff, so we were working with that, and only on a few particular songs, you know.
Yeah.
Because I tend to be, you know, traditionally minded sometimes when I'm writing.
We're moving to Shanghai, so don't you cry. We're moving to Shanghai.
I was classically trained in piano, and then I went on to teaching myself drums. I used to drum along to like Nirvana and stuff like that, you know, Guns N' Roses when I was about 13, just with a Walkman, you know. And then I just moved on to guitar, bass and everything else that I could possibly.
Have your parents got a sort of musical blood?
Not really. On my mother's side, I think both her parents were very musical, amazing pianists, and her great aunt was like a harpsichord player from the 1920s, who was meant to be quite famous. But
Is your mum not then? Is she not musical?
No, not really, no.
Skipped a generation.
Kind of, yeah, I'm a bit of a freak.
Drip on the crimson tears drip on the blood-stained wall I wore. Do 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 do.
Now there's a lad who'll go far, and he's in the region, and you took a bit of a shine to him, I noticed.
I did. He's going to be at the boat race in Cambridge on Saturday if you want to see him, but there's more gigs as well. Catatonia, the Welsh Popsters, are going to be at the Cambridge Corn Exchange on the 30th of July. This is a really welcome return with them. They've got a new single out called Stone by Stone, and no doubt it'll be a massive hit, just like Road Rage and all the other ones they had. Now this next one's for all the old hippies out there. Country Joe McDonald is going to be at the Waterfront in Norwich on the 23rd of July. Some people might remember him for Woodstock, some might remember him for his big hit What We're Fighting For. He's actually made 35 albums of Delta Blues and Country Rock, so it really is an opportunity to go and see a legend at work. Young British indie band Seafood are going to be at the Bedford Esquires on the 21st of July. They supported the likes of Idlewise, so they will be grungy, noisy, but they have got a few sort of poppy songs in there as well, just to make it a bit more melancholic. Continuing its residency, Pam's House is going to be at the Opium Lounge in Ipswich on the 20th of July. Pete Walkden, Paul Gardner, Rob Hyperactive and Marmot are all going to be there taking you through from funky stuff to real hard stuff later on till 3 a.m.
Brilliant. Thanks a lot, Cara. Now for this week's video release, and it's directed by Sally Potter, and it's called The Man Who Cried. The story's set in 1927, and it's about a young Jewish girl, played as an adult by Christina Ricci, who's sent to England by her Russian family to escape persecution. 10 years later, she begins a new life in Paris, where she joins the chorus of an opera company. There, she falls in love with a gypsy horse handler, played by Johnny Depp.
Please, mes amis. Tonight we're lucky to have with us the guest star of Felix Perlman's new opera company. So please welcome Dante D'Amelio, who has kindly agreed to sing something for us.
The film also stars Kate Blanchett as a Russian dancer, and John Turturro is fantastic as a hammy opera singer. The photography is stunning, and Johnny Depp speaks less in this film than any I've ever seen him in. But then it's enough just to look at him, isn't it?
Hold it, Felix. You really want me to stand here, huh? Not over there, huh?
Over there, Dante.
Here, you blocked the entrance of the horse.
The horse?
It looks good, Dante.
Eat look good. Felix, tell me, is this opera or a spectacle?
I see no contradiction.
Allora, I put another way. Do you want the public to look or to listen?
Both, Dante, both, the eyes and the ears. It's opera for the people, and the people need to be entertained.
I came to Paris to sing. Strangely, I believe the public are coming to listen to me. not to look at scenery or horses. But then what do I know, huh? I am just a foolish singer.
Well, that's just about that for this week. I hope you've enjoyed the show, and I'm going to leave you with Robbie Williams' latest single called Eternity, and hope to see you next week. Goodbye. For eternity. For eternity.
For eternity.